Louganis is leading by a large margin, entering the finals tonight with Ron Marriott of the U.S. second, Lei Hong Ping of China third. But let's look back to 1976, and Phil Boggs was the big story, diving to gold in that springboard competition. Phil, his gold medal dive, Olympic champion, world champion, AAU champion, NC2A champion, he stayed very much involved in the sport of diving. He now presently is on the governing board of diving. It's so nice for you to join us this afternoon.
My pleasure.
In 1976, the Soviets were there, and Soviet, I believe, got the bronze in your event. Phil, do you think that the Soviet and the Eastern Bloc, the absence of the Eastern Bloc countries, is hurting the diving competition?
Not really hurting the competition at all. It's taken away some of the finalists, but all the pre-Olympic medal favorites are here. The United States and the People's Republic of China are the two strongest diving powers in the world.
Well, as you say, China, let us look at the diver now who is currently in third place, Lei Hong Ping. And we're about to see his dive yesterday that put him into the finals, and also a slow motion of his dive. Bill, what's his strength, his weaknesses?
His strength is his acrobatic ability. He's a graceful diver. He somersaults very, very easily. As you can see here, he had no trouble making the most difficult front somersaulting option we used. It's a forward 3 1/2 somersaults, and he finishes it probably higher than Greg Louganis, but yet his inaccuracy on the bottom causes him to lose points.
American Ron Marriott.
Well, Ronnie was a former world trampoline champion, and his...
And it shows, doesn't it?
Yeah, it sure does. His acrobatic ability is terrific. He pulled that dive, which was not a great takeoff, kicked and landed straight up and down. He doesn't jump nearly as high as Greg, but on this dive, he's what we call a smart diver. He waited till the last minute, kicked straight up and went in.
Well, of course, these dives aren't important anymore. All of those scores are thrown out as now they go into a clean round to tonight's finals. This man you know from 76, he was around then. Hard to believe, isn't he?
Hey, I'm glad I'm retired now watching him dive. It's just terrific. You saw the same dive that Lei Hong Ping did, but a better finish.
Is that the key to Greg's success, the finish?
Well, Greg's success is everything. He has the cat-like awareness to make the great finishes. He's got the timing and incredible grace. He makes it all look easy.
Well, he really is spectacular, isn't he?
He's a beautiful guy.
It's amazing that there's no splash. That's the one thing Frank Gifford and I constantly talk about. It's so easy as entry into the water. As you look back, do you think the competition was tougher in Montreal or now?
As I watch the dives that they're doing now, I'm glad I'm retired. They're doing more difficult dives now. And three things have changed, really. The rules have changed to allow them to perform more difficult dives. The equipment's improved, and the diver's training's improved.
You wish you were there? Out there in the pool tonight?
Yes and no. It's fun to be able to watch now, but
and have
a little bit of stirring.
And you have a great deal of involvement, I'm sure, as being, what is your proper title?
Well, I'm currently president of the National Governing Body, but that's my volunteer position.
Oh, that's wonderful. And you're an attorney in Florida.
Yes.
Well, Phil, it's nice for you to be with us. Thank you very much. And, of course, you'll be out at the diving finals tonight, out at the USC Swim Stadium. Well, you know, Al Troutwig has been all around town for us, looking at competition that we often don't get to see in the